So, good morning students. Today I want to explain about the IRDA and its function. So after the recommendation given by the Malhotra committee has submitted the report in the year 1994. So after taking the 5 years, the government of India want to establish one regulatory body to regulate and control the insurance business in the country. So the Malhotra committee has recommended that one independent regulatory body should be there to regulate and control the insurance business, as well as they want to increase the insurance business in the country, as well as they want to protect the interest of the policyholder. To do all these things, they want to establish one regulatory body. So the IRDA came into existence in the year 1999. So this act was passed in the parliament, and this act came into force in the year 2000. The IRDA was established in the IRDA came into force in the year 2000. So the IRDA, so if you go for the IRDA and its function, so IRDA and act also IRDA act as a statutory regulator to regulate, promote the insurance industry. So IRDA act was passed in order to regulate the insurance business in the country. So the members of the IRDA was appointed by the central government. Whoever the members are there in the IRDA, that members are selected by the central government. So here the IRDA, the headquarters of the IRDA exists at Hyderabad. So what are the organizational structure of the IRDA? So what is the organizational structure of IRDA? So for the IRDA, one chairman will be there. The chairman will be there in that position for 5 years, and the maximum age that chairman should have 60 years. And we are having the 5 old time members. So for the 5 old time directors, the period for the term of these directors will be 5 years, and the maximum age is 62. So the maximum age to act as a director, the maximum age is 62. And we are having the 4 part-time members, and the term of these members should not be more than 5 years. This is about the organizational structures. So here one chairman we will have, 5 old-time directors, 4 part-time members will be there in the IRDA. So what are the objectives of IRDA? So why we should have the IRDA, and what are the objectives of the IRDA? So to protect, promote and safeguard the interest and rights of the insurance industry. That is the objective of the IRDA. It want to protect the insurance industry, they want to promote the insurance industry, and they want to safeguard the rights and the interest of the insurance industries. Next one is the growth and expansion of insurance industry. So they want to increase the insurance industry, and they want to expand the insurance industry in the country. Next, quick settlement of genuine claims. Whenever the insurance company will get the genuine claims, so the quick settlement can be done with the help of the IRDA. Means this is the objective. So whatever the genuine claims the insurance company is getting, that genuine claims can be solved as early as possible. That is also one of the objective of the IRDA. Next, transparency and orderly conduct of the financial market dealings. So it's transparency. So whatever the premium the insurance companies are collecting, so that will be invested in the company shares. So it should be transparently and orderly conduct. So how the amount should be invested in the shares and the debentures, so that will be given by the IRDA. The suggestion will be given by the IRDA to the insurance industry. So it is the transparency and orderly conduct of the financial market dealings. Next, what are the duties and functions of IRDA? First, so the duties and functions of the IRDAI certificates to the insurance company. The companies who want to start the insurance business, they have to get the certificates from the IRDAI. So these certificates will be provided by the IRDAI to the insurance company. That is the first function of the IRDAI. Second one, protection to the interest of the policyholder. So the main objective of the IRDAI is they want to protect the interest of the policyholder. No policyholder should suffer the any problem from the insurance business. So for that purpose, the IRDAI was established. The main objective of the IRDAI is they want to protect the interest of the policyholder. That is also one of the duty of the IRDAI, to protect the interest of the policyholder. Next one is the license for the intermediaries. Whoever is acting as an intermediary for the insurance business, so these intermediaries will get the license from the IRDAI. Without the license from the IRDAI, these intermediaries can act as an intermediary for the insurance business. So that is also one of the duty of the IRDAI. Next, regulates and supervise the premium rate. So what will be the premium rates? That will be decided by the IRDAI. So how much premium should be there, how much premium should be collected by the insurance company for the policies, that premium rates will be decided by the IRDAI. So that is about the regulate and supervise the premium rates. Next one is the regulate the investment of the policy holders. So whatever the amount we are collecting from the policy holders, that amount will be invested in the shares and the debentures. So this IRDAI will regulate the investment of the policy holder, where we have to invest that amount. That suggestion will be given by the IRDAI to the insurance companies. Next, maintenance of the solvency margin. Every insurance company has to maintain the solvency margin. So whenever any natural disasters occurs, the insurance company should ready to pay the claim amount. So that is why they have to maintain the solvency margin in the insurance companies. So how much solvency margin should be maintained by the insurance company, that will be decided by the IRDAI. How much they have to maintain the solvency margin in the every insurance company, that will be decided by the IRDAI. Next one is the requisite qualification code of conduct of practical training for the intermediary. So what are the qualification required to act as an intermediary, and how the practical training should be given for the intermediary will be decided by the IRDAI. So they will provide the what are the qualification and how the practical training should be given to the intermediaries will be done by the IRDAI. That is also one of the duty of the IRDAI. So delegate the authority of the IRDAI. So whatever the powers are there, that will be given to the authorized person. Means they will delegate the authority of the IRDAI. Next one is the license cannot be issued in favor of a minor and the unsound mind. So the IRDAI will not give the license to the minor person as well as the mentally disordered person. So unsound mind person will not having any right to get the license to act as an intermediary. Next, so the IRDAI will provide the agent license for the 3 years. So after completing these 3 years, the agent have to renew his license. So this is about the duties and functions of IRDAI. So full form of the IRDAI is Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority. Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India, IRDAI.